female singer, and that's Dina Carroll, and she'll be singing about her perfect year and hopefully talking about it as well after this. Welcome back. Dina Carroll there with Don't Be a Stranger, one of the songs that won her the title of Best Female Singer at this year's Brit Awards. And not a stranger this morning.
No.
Here on the couch, all the times
at
you have
last.
Been.
Yeah. I can't believe it. I know it sounds trivial to everyone else, but I've tried to get on this couch for how long? A year? I've finally been allowed on.
It's just been a question of timings and things.
Is that
we
what it
desperately
is?
Wanted
no,
to
you've
speak
been
to
putting
you.
Me off for ages.
No, we have not. We have not. The last time now you were here, mm-hmm. you were singing Perfect Year.
Yeah.
How perfect a year otherwise has it been for you?
This one just gone. It's been nice. I've gone underground, well, what I call underground, literally in the studio for most of this year. So it's been really good. It's been away from all the promotional work and mainly the stress of being out there all the time. Because, what was it, 93 was a really, you know, rushed, compact year for me. Very successful, but everything was so fast I didn't have time to relax and take it in.
And that was the year that really launched you to fame,
as it were. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
It was the best.
Of course, one of your claims to fame is, I suppose, the unusual way in which you came into the world.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Tell us about that. Well, I'm sure you don't remember a lot about it, but it was different.
Well, there's some great stories that my mother won't allow me to tell about that. I was actually born in the back of a taxi. And if you can imagine her trying to get out of the taxi, because my head was actually showing, you know. So we had a few problems with that.
Oh, dear. And this was in where? Newmarket?
Yeah,
Newmarket, of all places. And you grew up on American Air Force bases,
on and
was
off.
That
I
right?
Kind of...
Your dad was American and your mother's British.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where the accent comes from.
Yeah, it's a bit of a mix, isn't it?
Yeah. Do you remember much about life on an Army base?
Air Force, I do. It was like a good time for me because, you know, racially, really, I never seemed to fit in the English school that I went to. So when I moved on base with my aunt, it was like a lot of kids were mixed blood, and it was just, I think, a lack of knowledge as far as the kids in school were concerned. But I went to a place where, you know, my hair was, you know, accepted and my features were. So it was, you know, it was a good move for me. That was when I was about 14.
Gosh, it's strange now when you think of your success now that you're talking about whether your hair should be accepted or your face should be accepted.
Yeah, they've become assets rather than a hindrance that they used to be when I was a teenager.
Now, flirting. Let's talk about flirting.
Yeah.
We are doing an item on flirting today on the program. Now, a big star like yourself, are you good at flirting?
I don't know. I find that hard to judge. I tend not to be, I think, because I put my head down too quick. You know, I'll have a quick look. I think it's all eye contact as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah.
It depends. Maybe if I've had a glass of wine, I'll be more relaxed about it and I can have a quick look. But
I suppose you flirt behind a microphone as well, I suppose.
Yeah,
I
flirt with the cameras and TV presenters and...
And all these beautiful love songs that you're going to sing. But are you happy we've talked enough now?
Yes.
I want you to get your full value out of this couch now because
it's
not too
bad actually
taken
here, is
so
it?
Long because we want to hear you singing.
Yes, fine.
Well. What are you going to sing for us this morning?
The Perfect Year again.
Yeah. Well, if you go over and make yourself ready for that, we'd be delighted to listen to you.
All right.
And if you make your way over there, Dina.
Okay.
I can tell people that Dina is going on tour. She's tour starts on the 2nd of December, Friday the 2nd of December. She starts in Bournemouth. She then tours around Scotland, Ireland and Wales. There are 15 dates in all as she travels around the country. The last one on Friday, December the 23rd. So there you are. If you want to see her, I'm sure she's coming somewhere near you. Here she is, Dina Carroll, The Perfect Year.
Ring out the old. Yeah.
It's New Year's Eve, and hopes are high. Dance 1 year in, kiss one goodbye. Another chance, another start. So many dreams to tease the heart. The perfect year. Ooh. The perfect year.
Oh. Wonderful.
It's Dina.
Dina Carroll
with us tonight because she's usually too busy picking up awards. Here singing Express is Dina Carroll.
And we just received news, that's right, isn't it, that she's finally passed her cycling proficiency test. Will you please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, the fantastic Dina Carroll!
Fight. Oh, I don't understand.
and a band of world musicians. Please welcome Dina Carroll.
Lying here all alone in the shadows, I believe when I sleep all the pain's gonna fade away. I can dream, can I? When I close my eyes, kiss the world goodbye, I dream of escaping to a land far away through the nighttime. There's a secret place where no one can hurt you, desert you. No one hurts you. That's why I'm escaping. Oh, 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 it's hard to say goodbye, knowing that when I try to forget you, love brings reality home. I keep my heart up on the shelf, hiding inside myself. What am I doing? No use in faking. Well, love is forsaken. It's so hard escaping your love.
There's a love made for me waiting out there. Till that day comes along, I'll be strong, I will make it through. I can dream, can I? When I close my eyes, kiss the world goodbye. This time I'm escaping.
Knowing that when I try to forget you, love brings reality home.
Welcome back. 2 years is a kind of lifetime in the pop industry, but Dina Carroll decided she needed that kind of break to come to terms with the pressures of fame. But she is back. She's got a new album and a new outlook, I suppose. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Just a very quick chat before you sing for us.
Sure.
What was it? Was it the fact that people recognised you, or the pressures of making lots of money?
I was working with a team that was fairly inexperienced as far as success and everything else goes. So whenever I went to them for advice, saying, how do I handle this with my family, or how do I handle this situation, they didn't know what to tell me because they had no experience in...
Yeah.
In, as I say, success.
And it screwed you up.
The pressure was quite immense, and I didn't know it was going to be so big.
Yeah.
So I didn't know what to expect and experience.
What was it? Was it mostly the press, or was it?
Press were pretty good to me. I think I'm pretty boring. I think I bored the press. That's why they didn't. Plus, I live in Cambridge, so that I wasn't available for them to to do anything. But I had a couple of bad experiences, not many. It's that I'm such a private person as well that I didn't know how to handle, you know, the people in my life being so familiar with me, as you know, when people see you on television, they think they know you very well.
Well, it's as if you become two different people, isn't it?
Yes, it is, yeah.
Are you very close to your family? Because you say you go back to Cambridge as much as you can.
I need to get away from the London scene. I think if I was here, I'd be too accessible for, like, everyone. Oh, could you just pop here and do this, just pop there and do that?
Yeah.
I need to get away. I just feel like all the pressure's easing as I drive up the M11.
Right. Yeah.
So. But you've spent, I mean, you know, we say you've been out of the public eye, but you've been writing, haven't you? You've been,
yeah, you say that. So Close was released in 1993, and I promoted that for about 2 years. That took me into, the last single was 1994, The Perfect Year. Mm. So I started recording
that was
in
nice
1995.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Started recording in 95, and that took me to early 96, plus I changed record companies as well. So quite a lot has happened.
But it's all been going on below the surface.
Yeah, really, kind of thing, really. Like. So people think, I don't know what they thought. Well,
go on, Julie.
I was just going to say, you're back with a new record which is released today called Escape. Right. And is that part of the album, is it?
Yeah, Escaping.
Escaping, sorry.
Yes, okay.
Forgot the last syllable.
That was chosen. I didn't want to come out and be predictable. I didn't want to come out with a big ballad, and I didn't want to come out with a dance track because I think people would have expected that. I wanted something slightly unique, and I think this song has it.
I always feel when I hear your voice, you've got so much power back there. It's as if you're only letting maybe about 2/3 of it out. I always feel that you've got a lot in reserve. You could really belt it if you wanted to.
Like doing that.
Yeah?
Yeah, I do like doing that. I think I've done it more on this album than the other album.
Right. Let it go.
Yeah. Yeah. Let rip.
Yeah. What's your influence then? I mean, because as soon as people hear you sing, you know it's you. I mean, but you must have based some of your musical style on influences.
It's many different singers, but it's all soul-based, you know, R&B. Yeah. My mother was like a soul fanatic, absolutely loved it. Al Green, The Temptations, all that style of music. 60s, 70s, 80s. Yeah. Soul music, so it comes from that.
So you've been singing since you were little, basically?
Yeah.
Singing along to your mother's favourite records or something?
Yeah. Unfortunately, there's a couple of photographs of that as well, somewhere.
Oh, sure. But how did you actually break into it, mainstream? What did you...
I went into a talent show when I was about 14 and met the band through that, but eventually, and I didn't win either, I got through to the semi-finals, but eventually we decided just to go straight to the horse's mouth. We went to a record company in London when I was 16, and I just stood and sang for them. We had an appointment. My mother pretended she was my manager. And they said, great, we'll sign you up right here and now. I just sang along to a tape, which
That's
thought was highly unusual, but it was all I could do because I didn't have the money for a demo.
I
could only afford the ticket down there.
Well, I'm glad you're back, and that's
you.
A lovely suit.
Thank you.
A bit like the fashion we've been looking at.
It is actually, it's the 70s there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, listen.
If you'd like to go over there,
absolutely.
Hit the stage.
All right.
Good luck with it.
Thank you very much.
Escaping, and you're seeing it in just a minute.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. See you later.
Thank you.
Right.
And I'm afraid from us, not from Dina, but from us, that's it for today. Tomorrow we'll be talking to the best-selling female author in Britain, the woman behind all those warm Irish sagas like Circle of Friends. That's Maeve Binchy. Monty Don's back with an autumn harvest from the garden, and there's live music from Suggs.
And we'll be talking to the ex-cop and his wife, who used to be a nurse. They quit their jobs, and now they've made a fortune from a new joint venture running sex chat lines. The series Parent Power looks at the nightmare of getting your children to do homework. What a weekend we had. And the taste testers panel get really aggressive and they knock the skin off some rice puddings. The tin versions get canned by them tomorrow. But we'll leave you now with Dina Carroll and her new single, released today, Escaping.
Escaping.
See you tomorrow. Okay, bye. Dina.
Lying here all alone in the shadows, I believe when I sleep all the pain's gonna fade away. I can dream, can I? When I close my eyes, kiss the world goodbye, I dream of escaping to a land far away through the nighttime. There's a secret place where no one can hurt you, desert you, no one hurts you. That's why I'm escaping. Oh, 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 it's hard to say goodbye, knowing that when I try to forget you, love brings reality home. I keep my heart up on the shelf, hiding inside myself. What am I doing?
me waiting out there till that day comes along. I'll be strong, I will make it through. I can dream, can I? When I close my eyes, will the tears run?